you think of this time for us about photosynthesis? Celsius on tip of my motor with carbon dioxide. Gonna see electrons go for a while. Bright and sugar, maybe sweeter too. But why should photosynthesis matter to you? Food on your table or to rich atmosphere. Without photosynthesis, you simply wouldn't be here. Reaction powered by light using enzymatic action. Waters oxidize CO2 to produce the sugar that results in drinking orange juice. The overall reaction has two phases. First is the light reaction, which is as it phases light by one production of ATP. O2 is the byproduct that you will see. Production of electrons and NADPH, which provides our juice of power needed in the second phase. NADPH during phase 2 provides most needed for reducing CO2. NADPH is made by a reduction of NADP plus, whose function is to absorb electrons to pick up H, gaining energy, making NADPH. Phase 2 is the calcite for things called the hydrates, the sugars and starches and fibers on the lunch plate. The cow plants make foods animals eat. Photosynthesis, it's so sweet. In a leaf, there's mesenchymal tissue and cells with chloroplasts, key to the issue. Chloroplasts are almost like cells in every way, with their own ribosomes and their own DNA. They even reproduce themselves, splitting into half. A clue for the solar cells' independent path. The theory has a name. Endosymbiosis developed in the 60s by Lynn Margulis. Inside a chloroplast is a fluid stroma. It's true in Tokyo, it's true in Roma. Stroma surrounds, filled by the coins. Each one has a hollow space inside. The thylakoids, membrane, is loaded with protein. This is the light reaction scene. It's all about using light for powering electrons. All about radical powering photons. Photons created are those from light, which has the energy to make the world bright. The highest frequency that we can see is by the light wavelength 380. 380 nanometers is the cell small. The next gamma rays is rather tall. Red light shines at 750. Is it the visible spectrum? If the photons are packets of light energy, both the wave and the particle you see. Photons get absorbed by pigments. It's real, it's true. It ain't no pigment. Most important are green chlorophylls. Orange caterpillars and yellow centrophils. Together they absorb light, most of red and blue. The green is not absorbed, it comes back to you. In chlorophyll, see the porphyrin ring. See the magnesium, which makes you want to sing. Magnesium metal with valence too. You see those electrons hopping through. Notice the tail, a hydrocarbon chain, which enters chlorophyll into the thylakoid membrane. A molecule style, so pretty. In the thylakoid, it makes electricity. It shows the action spectrum. Use the prism to break the sun's light into its frequencies. Show it on spiral jar of filaments, algae. Eotriology make it stimulate bacteria, which will grow in any oxygen materia. Bacteria nothing over blue and red, but hardly grew over green, they might as well be dead. The line of growth is a reflection of photosynthesis action spectrum. No, this won't match exactly the absorption spectrum of chlorophyll layer B. Cosmic character noises and the bills we met absorb light frequencies before it goes again. And in the thylakoid, they all cooperate. It uses light to synthesize carbohydrates. Consider chlorophyll in isolation. Shines upon a light called a photoexcitation. The valence electrons in magnesium. Jump to it inside the baby, it's so fun. But once up at that level, they can only fall. After where they started, like a bouncing ball. These falling electrons release energy. Fluorescing is red light, as you can see. But inside the core, chlorophyll's not alone. Instead of photosynthesis, it's chlorophyll's home. The photosynthesis parts contain photons and use their energy to move electrons. The systems of the complex is the first capture, changing photon energy into electron rapture. The energized electrons bounce like a ball. At the reaction says appear, they jump up to that ball. A primary electron center grabs up from on top and yanks it with a force reaction center cannot stop. To the oxidized reaction center will return, but the details of electron flow have now it's time to learn. Non-cyclic flow is the main pathway. Much confusion relates to the way photosystem 2 proceeds. Photosystem 1 is about to memorize, just get done. PS2's a antenna captures a photon, generates a flow of electrons all around the world. Even in Haiti, they flow to reactor center P680. Their electrons do not hover. Electron sector passes them over to the electron transport chain in the thylakoid membrane. This chain's like the bucket brigade. Each molecule has a similar trait. They take in electrons and use their energy for pumping protons from stroma to the thylakoid space, packing protons into that place. This makes a great plus a thylakoid membrane. The protons want out, although insane, but the protons can't permeate. The membrane won't allow escape. There's only one port through which they travel. It's the ATP synthase channel. The ATP uses an enzyme which makes ATP all the time. It has binding sites for ATP and B. A channel switch of using photons to kinetic energy changes the binding sites conformation. Using ATP with peak performer information is how thylakoids make ATP, life's key form of energy. For respiration, this might feel familiar. ATP is made this way in mitochondria. Kinesiosmosis is the name. ATP production is the game. Electrons moved by the sun, flowing from photosystem to the system one. They get to the S1 like they use the battery. The transfer chain uses up their energy. But when light hits PS1's antenna, electrons bounce to reaction center. This works P7O. The wavelength makes electrons go. PS1's electron center grabs them away. P7O in an oxidized way. P7O in an oxidized blues accepts the electron from PS2. Back to electron from PS1, it never goes for a ride, having it so fun. A powering hook ups hate its fate. The travels to ATP plus reductase. The enzyme plant cells count the pond to pass up H and electrons. The ATP plus, which gets reduced, it's how NADPH gets produced. Like reactions as oxygen, here's how it happens. Back on PS2, it came to arise. P680 got oxidized. To replace those electrons, P680 liberates electrons from the water, which associates to one oxygen and protons too. The single globe will need another forming of two. These protons are formed in the thylakoid space, increasing proton concentration in that place. So we see a side effect of water's oxidation is enhancement of ATP creation.